What's up guys, you're watching Tech AMA and this is another iOS 8 walkthrough video. And if you managed to miss my last iOS 8 walkthrough video, then you can click right over here. But this video is about photography on iOS 8, so I'm going to be showing you guys some new camera features in iOS 8 and some improvements in the Photos app as well. Well, let's just jump straight into it. Opening up the camera app, at the bottom you can straight away see this new mode called Time Lapse, which allows you to record videos and have them play back at a very fast speed, which would be a very nice way to record the sunset and any other things which you just want to record and have played back really fast. Next up, iOS 8 also brings you with a camera timer. The time has two settings, 3 seconds and 10 seconds. This isn't an all that wow feature, but at least it's there, so I can set the timer for 3 seconds and it will take a picture just like that. When taking photos, you can now manage the exposure yourself, giving you control over how much light enters through the camera's lens, which is a really nice feature, so you now have more control over your picture quality. As you can see right now, I'm recording the light, and as I'm increasing and decreasing the exposure, the brightness increases and decreases. And editing your photos is now better than before. There's many different ways you can adjust your photos to get much better edited pictures. Over here under the light tab, you can mess around with the exposure, brightness, shadows, and much more as you can see right now. In the color tab, you can change the saturation, contrast, and cast. And finally, in the black and white tab, we have the options to change the intensity, neutrals, tone and grain, and to be honest, I don't even know what most of these mean. So anyway, if you want to compare your color edited version of the picture with the black and white version you made, you can just switch back and forth like this. Cropping images is basically the same, but what's new is that photos automatically straighten horizons to give you the best crop. So for example, this picture I took which is off axis and I want to straighten it, well, I don't have to do anything because look at this. So you created your masterpiece, it's saved. Now what? Well, you can now favorite your favorite pictures and they will automatically be added into this album. And surprise, surprise, the album is called Favorites. So you can access all your favorite pictures straight away. And iCloud photo sharing is a very cool thing which lets you create albums and invite other people to subscribe to it. So whenever you post a new photo in the album, it will come up on the subscriber's shared album as well. So over here I have an iPod Touch 5th Gen and I would like to create a shared album. I just tap the plus sign and name the album. So I'm just going to name this Family Photos. And accept it from my iPhone. I noticed that when I add a picture from the iPod to the album, it will appear on my phone as well. Pretty cool, right? In addition to just adding pictures, you can also comment on other people's pictures.
Hang on a minute, where's the camera roll? It's not there.
Oh my god, all my pictures are gone.
Well, no they're not. They're just over here in the collections. And if you're looking for a picture you took on, say, your birthday 3 years ago, but can't find, what you can do is type in the date or location you took the pictures and it will bring up the photos you were looking for. And show you the exact time you took the picture. Don't like your photos? Then delete them. Twice. Yes, you now have to delete photos twice in order to permanently remove them from your device. For example, if I want to delete this picture of these nice cupcakes, I'll delete it as usual, but say I now change my mind and I want it back, I can just go into the recently deleted album and recover the pictures exactly back to where it was. Or I can delete it again to permanently delete it. Alright guys, so that was a walkthrough of photography on iOS 8. Be sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed, and feel free to comment what you think about photography on iOS 8. And Subscribe as well for more tech videos. I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching.